from the Red Gate. Ladies and gentlemen, this is David
again. You know, this Bruce McTavish stays back. He's one of the very best referees in the world.
Oh, he caught him! And he caught him again! Shane's ready to go! And he's down in round one!
Ricochet's in a heap of trouble. He won't be able to recover from this.
He's trying to get up too quick.
He comes forward. McTavish will give him all the time in the world. David judges him. It's going to be a front drop knockout. Down he goes again.
Oh, that's a disqualification.
I don't know about that.
It won't be, but I'm just saying. He hit him while he was on the floor.
And five and six and seven. He's got the eight count. He brings his hands up. He's called timeout. Bruce McTavish has called timeout. And we're at the very end of the round. I'm not sure why he called timeout. Shane's down twice in the first round, so it didn't take long. A lot of the questions have already been answered. The power of two is still there, and Shane won't last long with him. He can't recover from those two big shots.
That was a knockout. The fight was over. There was no response by Cameron, but this that's the first knockdown. His second knockdown, he hit him twice while he was on his knees. Down, look. Oh, that's the first one still.
He's down.
There, hit him. You see, this second knockdown, he hits him while he's on the floor twice. Look at that. On the floor. On the floor.
Yeah, he does. Now, Bruce McTavish called timeout at the very tail end of the round. I don't know why. But he did hit him down twice, and it could have been a disqualification.
Cedric Kushner was going wild in the corner saying the fight was over. This is the David two that we all thought would have come to fight Lennox Lewis. Where was he?
Big difference in the skills of Shane and Lennox. Shane's eyes are both puffy. And now let's see if David can keep the pressure on him. He knows what he can do. Shane backing off immediately. He's trying to jab. Gets hit again with a right hand. Left hook. He's not going to last this round. David's on him. He's pummeling. The referee stops the fight. It's all over. A second round knockout victory. And Shane is hurt. That shows you David Tua is back.
My God, that was devastating. But listen, I've got to look. He's a friend of mine, Bruce McTavish. But I've got to question the referee. He didn't take too many punches there. Too many punches.
Shane took at least seven or eight clean blows. McTavish, of course, didn't want to stop it too quick, but, you know, I'm not going to take the judgment away from the referee in this particular case. I don't know what went on with the two punches when he was on his knee. A little bit of controversy in there. But there's no question it was academic. David Tua pummeled this guy and did what he has to do to jump back on the scene. That's a brilliant knockout victory for David Tua.
That's devastating. Look, like I said, obviously I know Lennox Lewis is different, but if that kind of guy came out against Lennox Lewis, who knows what could have happened?
He was cool in the early going of the fight. And, I mean, he just really devastated. Here's David over there saying, you know, now this shows the sportsmanship of the two guys.
Well, nobody's ever doubted what a gentleman David Tua is.
My heart goes out to Shane because I know how hard he worked to get ready for this fight. He's a wonderful guy. Guy raised in the shadows of motherfucker. But Naki. The mountain warrior might have been from the mountains, but he wasn't the warrior tonight. It wasn't his night. David Tua's career gets a whole new blast. And now the big talk is, will Tua come back and fight Hasim Rahman for a third time here?
Ladies and gentlemen, with just 7 seconds into round number two, your winner by knockout, David the Terminator Tua!
That is exactly